over the next topic today in controlling, we will discuss internal order. So let us try to understand what is an internal order. Internal order is a CO object used to record expenses and revenues. And predominantly, you know, it is used for recording expenses. So why do we require an internal order when we are having a cost center? I won't even write revenues, but predominantly it is used to record expenses. And let us try to understand how the internal order is different for a cost center. So let us take a scenario. You're having in your organization, there is a event going on. Okay, there is some event, some live performance event is being conducted for the employees in the organization, like how in any company performs usually at some point of the time. This company is also having a live performance event, and this event has various expenses. It need to pay for the performers, it need to pay for the decorations, it needs to pay for the electricity expenses. Assume anything, this is such kind of an event where there is no revenue involved, but you know, it is just for the purpose of recreational activities of the employees. So it has a lot of expenses involved in it. They need to pay for the electricity, they need to pay the employees who are working, or probably they might hire some third party company in order to do entire setup for this event. They need to pay for them, and main performers also charge something, so they need to pay for them also. So these are the various types of expenses that are present. And let us assume this live performance event is being conducted by the HR team. The HR team is responsible. So in our case, it is a common HR team is responsible for conducting this event for all the employees, for both the plants, for mobile and laptops. So how will you record? Can anyone tell me, like, how will you record these expenses? Usually, what will you do, and what is the cost object that you use in FB50 while you are posting this document, and how will you record this different expenses? Any idea, any guess?
Come back to the question.
So these are the various expenses that are involved in conducting this event, and this event is being performed by the common HR team. Now, while performing the event, they are making some payments or making the bill payments. So they need to record these expenses in the FI system, right? So they will go to FB50 and they will record the expenses. So how will you do? What is the cost object that you will use while you are posting a document for this expenses?
Common
HR. You mean the cost center, right?
Yeah.
Right. You're completely right. So ideally, what common HR team has a cost center, which is common HR. And whatever expenses are being incurred by this common HR team, we can book onto that cost center directly. But now, for some more granularity, these expenses are something that are not a part of its operations, a part of a day-to-day operations of the HR team. Let us assume the HR team is responsible only for payment of salaries. So which means payment of salaries is its day-to-day work. But these expenses are not a part of day-to-day expenses. So now the management will think, like, okay, let us keep a separate track of these expenses. Instead of posting it to cost center directly, obviously at the end, these needs to be posted to the cost center only. So whatever expenses are incurred, you need to post to cost center. But instead of posting it directly, they want to keep a track of it as long as the event is going on. So let us assume this is a event that is going on for, suppose, 1 week. So all through this 1 week, they are having various expenses. And instead of posting it directly onto cost center and avoiding confusion in the reports, what they will do is they will create an internal order, and they will post all these expenses for this entire 1 week onto the internal order. Internal order is also a cost object which is used to record expenses. So internal order, the difference between internal order and cost center is that internal order is used for short term, unlike cost center, which is permanent. So what do you mean by short term? Short term is not having a specific duration, like only short term means 1 day or 1 hour or 1 week. It can be even 1 year or 2 years also, but it is not a permanent thing. So let us take another example. Now there is a construction going on. And for that construction, you know, you want to record these expenses for onto this internal order. And once the expense, once the construction expenses, everything is done, after the period of 1 year, you will settle all these, or you will transfer all these costs, whatever you booked onto internal order, to a cost center. That means a team which is responsible for that construction. So in our case, in this example, what will we do is, all through this entire 1 week, whatever postings you are doing, you will go to FB50 and you will make a posting. And instead of giving a cost center, you will give an order. A order in the sense, here in this case, it is an internal order. So this internal order will record all the expenses for that entire 1 week. And for the entire 1 week, these will not be posted to the cost center. So if you extract a report onto the cost center, there's an advantage of this kind of a structure, like how you are posting to the internal order. So what is the advantage? You will go to the cost center, you will generate a report, and the management will not be confused with the payments that are responsible for this live event. And the live event is not yet over. So instead of posting such kind of a transactions which are not yet over, there might be multiple other transactions for a similar type. So they are posting it to the internal order. And if the management wants to see how this, or what are the expenses that are being posted or that are being incurred for this event, then they will extract reports on the internal orders rather than the cost center. And once this event is performed, once this event is over, then they will generate a report on the internal order saying that, okay, these are the expenses that are incurred for this live performance event. And now, which team is responsible for this one? The HR team. So they will transfer all these costs from this internal order to the cost center. And this transfer of costs is called as settlement. So once the event is over, the costs on the internal order are settled. The process is called settlement to the cost center. Settlement is nothing but it is quite similar to what we saw. You know, we saw the transfer of costs, right? We gave the source cost center and a destination. It is called as sender and receiver. The source cost center is the sender who is sending the money. And receiver is the receiver cost center who is receiving the cost. So we gave a sender cost center and the receiver cost center, and we transferred the costs in this case. I'm talking about this one, the 10,000 rupees. Similarly, in this case, you will perform a settlement. A settlement is something which transfers costs from one cost object to another cost object. So in this case, the sender cost object is an internal order and the receiver cost object is a cost center. So there are various configurations that we need to perform for the internal orders, right from the master data to how we are going to perform the settlements and everything. Any questions on the concepts of the internal order, like why are we using an internal order and what is the advantage or how it is different to the cost center? Any questions?
No, Vira.
Okay. So now let us go to SPRO. Oh God, this is too slow. And guys, after the session, please do try contacting ACD and whoever is responsible or the SPOC for this user. Please contact that person and say, no transaction is working. It is giving an ABAP dump and we are not able to practice sessions. And please ask them to do it right today itself. We cannot afford leaving tomorrow also.
Sure.
Thank you. So internal order is a part of controlling, and here you are having internal orders. Yeah, so under internal orders, so the first one is you need to activate order management in controlling area. So while we were defining the controlling area, you saw activation of various components. We have activated all of those, but now let us go ahead and check once again what exactly is this component, this whether it is activated or not. So order management, you know, order management deals with various orders. Like you can go with production orders, which are used for production processes. And you can go with internal order, which we saw why we'll be using internal orders. So for any of this, if you want to use, you need to activate activate the order management component in the controlling area. Sorry guys. So this is our controlling area, and we are going to the activate components or indicators, and order management is component is active. So fine, let us go back. We are fine with this. And now let us go to the order master data. So order master data, first one is define order types. Order type is nothing but like how we were having different GL account types, like whether it is a profit and loss account or a balance sheet account. Similarly, we have different order types based on its functionality and based on how it is supposed to be settled and everything. So let us see what are the various order types. So these are the default order types from 100 to 1000. These are something that are provided by the SAP as a standard. And this is the model order. So fine, we need not bother about it. So let us go to, I won't say it as investment. Let us try to copy this investment and let us create a new one. We will say ABCC events. Okay. I will say ABCE. So I will say ABCC events. So we are having various fields in this one. Let us try to understand what does each field does. So settlement profile, we discussed, right? Once the event is over, whatever expenses are recorded onto this internal order needs to be settled to the responsible cost center. So how you are going to settle? Who will be the receiver of the settlement? Whether it should be a cost center, whether it should be an asset, whether it should be an element, cost element. So all those are determined from this settlement profile. So we will go to the configurations of settlement profile and we will try to understand. But for now, let us try to understand that settlement profile deals with how this costs on this internal order can be settled. So planning profile. What is the planning profile we are having? So it is just, you know, how you are going to, if you are having any plan values, how you are going to post onto this internal order. So that is dealt with this one. And the major advantage of using an internal order is budgeting. Everyone uses internal order for the main purpose called budgeting. Budgeting is nothing but how you are planning. Like earlier we saw, we have a cost center. We are planning for the cost center. Like, okay, this is the plan values. But while we're posting the actual values, it did not stop us from posting an amount that is more than the plan value. It is just a reference figure. It is saying, okay, the plan values are supposedly this much, but the actual values can be any amount. It can be more than the plan values, it can be less than the plan values, or it can be equal to the plan value. The system will not stop us. So now coming to the budgeting. Budgeting is a kind of planning, but here the system will give you an option to restrict the users from posting an amount which is beyond the budget. Or even if the budget is about to get over, it will give an error message or a warning message to the users saying that for this particular year or for this particular period, you have exhausted the budget that is allocated to this internal order. So this is how, you know, budgeting helps. You can give a certain amount for a particular period and you can control what should the system do if this budget is exceeded, or even if the budget is nearly exceeded, like 80% of it is over, then how you should inform it to the users. All this. So this is a kind of a more efficient planning which is possible in internal orders, and that is the reason many people use internal orders. So in our case, so let us assume that, you know, what is the budget that we are having? We are having a budget which is us some 50,000 rupees. 50,000 is the planned budget for this event. It is only for one particular period. It is not for the entire period, or probably whatever is the duration of this internal order, irrespective of how many months or how many weeks or how many years, this is the entire budget that people need to use. And we want to say that if some 80% of the budget is reached, then warn the users. So that means if you are trying to post onto this internal order and if already 80% of the budget is exceeded, then the system will give you a warning message while posting saying that, okay, 80% of the budget is already exceeded. And if 100% of the budget is reached, then give an error message. Which means the system will not allow you to post any more expenses onto this internal order because the budget has already been reached. then, you know, even if you still want to post for some reasons, then you need to contact your manager, whoever is responsible for this budgeting. That team will go to the finance team and they'll say, okay, this is a genuine request. We need to exceed the budget for some reasons, some unexpected reasons. And they will get an approval and they will increase the budget. So all this needs to be done. So this is what the budgeting profile does. And object class says what is the purpose why you are using this internal audit, whether it is an investment or it is an overhead cost or it is a production purpose or for profit analysis. So in our case, it is an overhead cost because these are the expenses which are occurring above the normal expenses of the business operations. So we are treating it as overheads and you can use it as overhead cost. CEO partner is active, yes. Commitment management, fine. We are not much bothered about it. And okay, fine. The status profile, it is also status management. Status management is nothing means you have various statuses of an internal order. Like first, while you are creating, it is in a create status. Like how you saw for the profit center, after the creation of a profit center, we have activated the profit center so that it can be used. Similarly, internal orders have three or four statuses, which we will see while creating the internal orders. And how those statuses are to be dealt, it is something that is decided from the status profile. So this is a standard status profile which you are using. And release immediately means there is a status for the internal order called release, like how you are having a status called activate for the profit centers. Similarly, you are having a status called release for the internal order. So unless and until the internal order is released, it cannot be posted onto. So there are two options on how you will release this internal order. Either you will go to manually to the internal order master data and click the release button once after you save it, or if you select this release immediately, you need not go manually and click this release button. Whenever you save the internal order, it is automatically released. So let us not select this and let us see how we need to do it. So this is our internal order order type. So I'm saving this value. ABCE is our internal order. And at least today I'll go to my own request. Okay. And save it. And the next one is maintain number ranges. So for every for profit centers and cost centers, we did not have any number range. We can give any alphanumeric ID for as its number. In this case, we are having, like, similar to GL accounts, we are having a number range. So we need to give a number range for our internal orders. So let us go to maintain number ranges. And let us go to edit intervals. So we are having this default number ranges already created. If you want, you know, you can edit and you can create a new one. But we will go with the existing ones. Let us see which one is free. Let us go to the number range 4. And you need to go to change groups. Here you will have your company code. Just search your company code or controlling area. ABCC is my controlling area. Okay, sorry, this is the order type. ABCE is my order type. Select this, go to assign, and select this group 4. Just select this one and click OK. So now you can see our ABCC is falling, ABCE internal order type is falling under the number range 4. So save it. Now status management. So we saw that how the status profiles are created and what does the status profile actually does. So these are the various status profiles. We have selected 002. So let us see what are the various characteristics that are present in this status profile. Okay, so this is the internal order status profile which we saw. Here you can see what are the various status. Okay, this is in German, so we are least bothered about it now. So these are the various details that they have maintained. So let us try and use some English one. Okay. Okay, so these are all the standard values, I believe. People have just copied the standard values. And it is completely in, okay, yeah, see here. So if you see here, there are various statuses. First one is created, next one is released, the next one is deletion not allowed, next one is no confirmation. So whatever it is, they have created various statuses which the internal order type would be using. And we are not going to change anything because we are completely fine with the standard settings. So screen layout is nothing but what fields are to be displayed. You know, these are all standard settings that will be taken, and we actually do not change anything unless until there is a specific requirement from customer saying that, okay, I need to see some additional field in the internal order creation screen. So this is the order master data. We have created this. Now let us go to planning, and under planning, exchange rate is fine. We do not need to maintain. Costing variant, we're not going to see it now. Fine, okay. So here you're having maintain settlement for plan values. So here you need to maintain settlement profiles or settlement structures. So let us see what is the settlement profile. So whatever we are doing this one, if you see, this is under the node called planning. So whatever the settlement profile that you are doing here is for the plan values that are posted onto the onto this internal order. So you need to select a settlement profile. So I'll say, let's select it as overhead costs. Now see how this settlement is to be done. So just let me go to, one second guys, let me go to the order master data and let us see. There is this internal order master data, order types. Does anyone remember what is the settlement profile that we have used in our ABCE order type? Is it 20 or 40? I think it is 40 because we have copied the investment one, so I think it should be 40. But let me check. Okay, it is 50. It is settlement profile. So I'll do it as overhead costs. Okay, let me save this with overhead cost and let us go to this maintain settlement and settlement profile. So settlement profile, I will go here in this overhead cost 20. Now we are having how and how much amount should be settled from this internal order. So first option is it should be settled in full. That means whenever you are settling this internal order, you can only settle all the 100% expenses that are already booked onto this internal order. Or it says can be settled means, you know, it is up to you. Like you are having 10,000 rupees on as an expense on this internal order, but you want to, for some reasons, you want to settle only 50% of this cost to your cost center. So you can do that. So the next one is not for settlement, which means this internal order will not be used as settlement object. You cannot perform any settlement onto this internal order. Now we will see allocation structure. Allocation structure, nothing but it defines what is a source object and what is a receiver objects for your settlement. So we will see that. PA transfer structure is a COPA thing. We need not discuss it now. So default object type. What is a default settlement object type? It will give you default value as a cost center. CTR is cost center. You can change it here. But for our case, we are requiring cost center. So we do not want to change it. So percentage settlement, you can, for settlement, you know, you need to create something called as settlement rule. Settlement rule defines, okay, who is the receiver, what is the receiver object, and what is the ID of the receiver. Like if you say receiver object is a cost center, then you will mention, okay, this is the cost center, like HR common is the cost center, and what is the percentage of the amount that this cost center will be receiving. Now in our case, we're having only one cost center as a receiver, which is the HR common. But let us assume, you know, there are two cost centers. Half of this is being taken care by admin team and half of the event is being taken care by the HR team. Then in that case, you will give the HR as well as admin team as two cost centers, as two receivers. Then in that case, you know, you can give a percentage of how much amount or how much expense is responsible for the admin team and how much percentage is responsible for the HR team. So that is the percentage settlement. Equivalence numbers, you know, you can also give in numbers also. That means the amount. Amount settlement, if you select this indicator, you can define the distribution rule and the settlement rule, which allows costs to be settled by the amount. So it says this is amount settlement. Let me activate this one. The equivalence numbers, according to which costs are selected proportionally. So equivalence numbers means, okay, this is a ratios. So instead of giving a percentage, you can give a ratios. Like you can give 1:2 ratio or 1:1 ratio. Then it will divide the entire amount in this ratio and it will post onto the receivers. So costing based profit center, profitability analysis, we are not discussing. So document type is SA. So once you run the settlement, what should be the document type? So we will say it as SA, and maximum, these are all not necessary. So here you are having various objects which you need to allow for your settlement. So whether you can settle it onto GL account, no. Cost center, optional. That means you can either settle onto a cost center or you can settle something else. So what are the allowed receivers? Valid receivers are cost center, order, WBS element, and a profitability segment. And there are some other objects which we did not discuss at this point. But for us, we require cost center, and cost center is settled as optional. You can either make it required or you can make it optional. But you know, this is a standard one. I do not want to change much. So let us go back and save it. So here you are having assigned number range for settlement documents. So did you understand what we discussed till now? Like what are we doing with settlement profile and what is the internal order, order type, master data and everything? Any questions till now on related to internal orders?
For me, no, Vira.
Okay. So if you see, we will be having ABCC. These are the cost object, and this is the document numbers for the settlement for plans. So ABCC, let me select this, our controlling area, and I will assign it to some group. Or I think it is already assigned to one group. No, it is not assigned. Okay. So save it. Settlement structure, you know, how the settlement profiles and everything are detailed here. I don't know why the system is very slow today. Okay. So this is the allocation structure. So we were discussing, right, what does this do, what are the sources and what are the receiver objects that needs to be allowed for this settlement. So we are going to cost allocation structure. So let us select A1. I'm just choosing A1 because this is what we have given in the order type. So I'll give it as A1, and let us go to assignments. So we're having various types of assignments, like whether you are, what type of costs are you settling? Whether it is a personal cost or a raw material cost, other cost, anything. Sorry. So randomly I've been choosing other costs, and I'll select source. Here you need to define what are the source cost elements which will actually post the cost onto your internal order. So earlier, while you are trying to post costs onto our cost center, we have used the GL account stationary expenses or probably HR salary expenses. So similarly, you need to have your own other GL accounts for posting the event related expenses. So what I will do is I will create a new GL account, a primary cost element. One second, let us, okay. So I will go to FS00. FS00, I will go to expenses. I will copy this existing salary expenses to A003. And here, let us make it as event expense. Okay. Event expenses. And remaining rest everything is same. Posting date, it is a primary cost element. And it is a cost account. And save it. So here, I need to maintain this source cost element, which is responsible for posting the costs onto this internal order. So unless until this is maintained here, whatever account, those costs which are posted by this GL account cannot be settled. So for example, now you have maintained E003. Now you are creating one more with E004, which is an electricity expenses. So this electricity expense GL account, if you do not maintain it in the allocation structure, and if you later on try to settle the costs from the internal order, it will give an error message saying this internal order is having postings from E003 and E004, but the allocation structure does not contain this E004 electricity expense GL account maintained as a source cost element. So it will not allow you to settle the costs that are posted by this source cost element. So let us put it like this. We will see what is the error that we will receive while we are trying to settle. And assessment cost element, we will discuss later, like what is an assessment and why we need to maintain. Now, settlement cost element. So here you need to maintain who is the receiver of this settlement. So in the settlement profile, we saw various valid receivers, right? We saw what is a valid receiver. There's a cost center, there is a WBS element, there is a real estate object, something and something. There are various valid receivers, out of which you need to mention it here, like what is the actual receiver. So in our case, receiver is a cost center. So I'll give it as a cost center. And here it is saying whether you want to settle by cost element or by cost element or settle cost element separately. So what does this mean is now you are posting E002 or 3. What is E003? It is an event expense. So you are debiting the expenses by 10,000 rupees and you are creating or you are posting this onto you are assigning the internal order. Your internal order name is suppose event internal order. Okay. So you are assigning this internal order onto this one. Now, after you want to settle these costs onto your cost center, so what should you do? Let us try to understand one thing. How your CO postings will affect FI postings. So till now we saw how FI postings are impacting the CO postings. So in the FI posting, this is an FI posting. On this GL account, if you assign any internal order or a cost element or a cost center, then that posting is now posted into FI. But settlement is something that is internal to controlling. It is something that is originating in controlling. Now, how will it impact your FI postings? Now tell me one thing. At the end of the event, you are trying to move these costs from your internal order to your cost center. Should this change the GL accounts which are posted? Like for example, what is the GL account that you are using for posting the expenses? You are using your event expense GL account. Now at the end of this event, you are transferring these costs. So at the end of the event, settle costs from event IO to HR common. So tell me, like at the time of settlement or after the settlement, should this be the same GL account? Like if you generate a report onto this GL account, should it still show this 10,000 rupees as your event expenses? Or should it be on some other GL account, or should it not be on any GL account?
GL account is the same only, but
right,
common account is different.
Sorry.
GL account should be the same, but cost center is different.
Right, which means the FI part, which is the GL account, is same. It should be the same because that is the GL account which you are using for booking the expenses. And the CO part, be it an internal order or a cost center or a profit center, whatever it is internal to the organization. In your financial report, you does not say that you have used this GL account to post onto this internal order. No one external to your organization will understand what is your internal order or what is your cost center, anything. It is completely internal to the organization. You can do anything you want internal to the organization for your managerial reporting. But when you are coming to legal reporting, this is the GL account that you need to use, and that will be remaining the same. Which means even after the settlement, that means even after a CO posting, it should not change the GL account, right? So that is what we are dealing here. So you are having by cost element. By cost element means, now if Okay, let us complete this posting. So what are the posting? It says A0001, which is our cash account. You are crediting by 10,000 rupees. Now, while you are settling this cost, from your internal order to cost center, the posting looks like this. E00003, which is your event expenses cost element, it will be credited with 10,000 rupees. And here, the internal order will be event IO. And another line item says E0003, event expenses, the same account. Now you will debit it with 10,000. Now, instead of giving an internal order, you will give HR common as a cost center. So try to understand what exactly is happening here. That means it is just posting a debit and a credit entry of same amount onto this GL account, which means from the FI perspective, the amount of this, the total amount of this document is zero. That means it is not having any impact on FI. Now, from the CEO perspective, the costs are being transferred from event internal order to HR common cost center, because the event internal order is being debited with 10,000. Here you're crediting with 10,000, which means the balance on the internal order is now zero. And here is a debit balance onto our cost center. So did you get it? Like, we are trying to transfer costs from our internal order to the cost center without making any impact on the FI. So is it clear?
Yeah.
Right. So this is what we are trying to say here by setting this by cost element. That means whatever cost element is used to post the expenses onto the internal order, you will use the same cost element to transfer the cost from internal order to HR common cost center. So this is how the posting will look if you are selecting by cost element. Now you're having another option like settlement cost element. So for some reason, you know, settlement cost elements, let us go to the GL account. Let us go to electricity expenses. Let us display and go to control data here. Sorry, should go to a secondary cost element. So this is assessment cost element. Display under the control data here for this assessment cost element, the category you have used is assessment. Here there is another thing called settlement, internal settlement. So I will use 21, which is an internal settlement. So I will create, if I create another secondary cost element with the cost element as internal settlement, or probably if I create a primary cost element with the category as external settlement. So in that cases, you are saying to the system that instead of using the same GL account, use a different GL account. Probably I'll say it is E0004. Okay. Although it will give me an error message saying that this is not a category 21 available. So what is a category 21? Category 21 is your internal settlement, which is a secondary cost element. So it should it will allow you to use a secondary cost element of internal settlement type. And always remember, secondary cost elements are not included in your financial reports. Secondary cost elements, as we discussed, is completely to internal to the organization, and these are not included in your financial reports. So what you are seeing by giving a secondary cost element here instead of choosing this one is, let the amount be remaining as it is on this one. You need not even post a zero balancing document on this one. Instead of using this account, it will say, okay, my secondary cost element is 001. It is a settlement cost element. Use this one to credit the event, credit 10,000 rupees onto event IO. And again, use the same one to debit the same amount onto the HR common cost center. Now, ignore this line. Now, this is the first case. Case one, it is by cost element. And this is a case two, we are giving settlement cost element. So we're giving a secondary cost element. So what is the difference? Now in the case two, let us try to understand how it is impacting the FI. The balance on E003 is remaining the same because it got debited once and it is not being debited or created anywhere. So from FI perspective, the balance on this GL account, and that means your event expense account and your cash account is same. It did not change. Again, same thing happened from the CO perspective. The balance has been moved from event IO cost center, internal order to your HR common cost center. Now, instead of using this GL account, there is a new entry in COPA or in controlling, where is a new secondary cost element, that is a second settlement cost element is being posted with zero amount. It is being credited with 10,000, it is being debited with 10,000. So ultimately the balance is zero on this cost element also, but instead of using this cost element for posting your settlement document, you are using this cost element. So FI and CO, the impact is completely the same. It is just that the cost element that is transferring the costs from this internal order to a cost center is different in both the cases. And what is the purpose of this one? If the business wants to avoid any unnecessary confusing entries onto this cost element, onto this GL account, the event expense GL account, then they will go with case 2, where they will give a settlement cost element and there will be no unnecessary postings onto this main source cost element. If they are fine with this cost, if they are fine with these entries, as ultimately the balance is zero, I mean the balance is not changing, so they will go with the case 1. Okay. Is it clear till this point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let us choose by cost element and let us save this. And save it. Okay, this entry is to be removed now. I mean, what happened is I just entered in the second one, so it is asking me to enter some value. So I'll delete this one and save it. Now the data is saved. So this is what we are discussing, we are dealing with in the allocation structure. We are saying what is the source cost element, what is the receiver cost element, what is the source or what is the receiver cost object. Okay, so whatever we did now is for planning. So as we saw in KP06 for cost center planning, there are transaction codes for internal order planning also. So if you want to post the plan values onto an internal order, that is what you will do. Now let us go to actual postings. Let us go to actual postings. And here also we will have settlements and everything. So let us deal with this settlement. So maintain settlement cost element. Settlement cost element is nothing but whatever we are creating, it will take us to FS00. If you want to create a settlement cost element or a primary cost element for a source, then you need to create it. Ultimately, it will just take us to the same transaction code FS00. You just need to create your GL accounts as per your requirement. See, it is going to the same transaction code. We already have the accounts, so we are not bothered. So same thing, maintain allocation structure. No good. I think today, you know, approximately 15 to 20 minutes is gone waiting for the screen to load. So well, let me try my luck. Let us post an FP50 document and let us go to KP06. Okay, so now this is for the actual postings. Entirely the same thing. I'm choosing again the same A1 and other costs as 30. And what is the source cost element? It is the same thing E003. It has already picked from the planned cost, whatever you have entered for the plan values. Assessment cost element, we are not discussing. Settlement cost element, same thing, cost center by cost element. So the same allocation structure for both plan and actuals. Settlement profile is also the same. Enter settlement profile and order types you have already entered. Maintain settlement profiles. Meanwhile, okay, KP06 is here. Let me check if it is working. Same thing, what is our settlement profile? It is 20. Double click on 20. It can be settled in full. Everything is active and these are active and this is the document type. peer transfer structure not bothered. A1 is entered here. Default type is cost center. So no changes required here because we have already maintained it. And number range for settlement documents also is maintained. Let us again check whether it has been accepted in for the actual postings or not. So the same thing, it is not working fine. So intervals, there are two intervals, 01 and 09. Let us go to this. Oops, it is our company called ABCC. Sorry, the controlling area. ABCC, is it assigned? Yeah, it is assigned to group one. Fine. So now we saw how the settlement related configurations are to be done for the internal order settlement. Now there is one more thing that we are discussing, that is budgeting. So we said, right, internal order, it will allow you to choose a budget. So budget related configurations are present in maintain budget profile. So let us go to budget profile. So what was the budget profile that we have entered? Let us go back and check. Does anyone remember what is a budget profile that we have used? There is only one budget profile. Perfect. We need not even worry. So budget profile, here it says, what is the time frame? That means this is the time frame that will allow you to choose the budget for or to allocate the budget for. So past one, future three, which means now you are in the month of December, or suppose assume you are in the month of June. Past one, which means the system will allow you to budget even for the 1 month back, which is May. So you can budget for both May and June, which is a past period, one past period and a current period. Similarly, you can enter budget for three upcoming periods like July, August and September. So at any point of time, the system will allow you to enter budget one period in past and three periods in future. So you can change it as per your requirement. You can make it 5 and 5, you can make it 2 and 2, depending upon how the business wants to do the actual budgeting for which periods. Depending upon that, it will you need to change the values here. So start is nothing but your current period. It says values which determine the start year for the planning or budget. So the reference value is the current fiscal year. So we need not maintain anything here. One second, guys. Yeah. So now next day we are having total values and annual values. So what is total values? Total values means the budget that you are entering, is it for the entire duration of this internal order or is it per year? So this will allow you to enter both. Like you can enter the entire values at once, which will be taken for all the years, or you can enter values individually for each year. So while you are entering the budget, in the budget entering screen, it will give you both options. You can enter via each for each year, or you can enter one amount for the entire duration of the internal order. So here is the exchange rate type. So if you are entering the budget, or if you are entering the budget in INR, but your postings are happening in some other currency, then it will use this exchange rate in order to convert that currency into US dollar, so that you know it can verify how much budget has been used. Value date, it will take based on the document if you do not mention anything here. Okay, this is fine representation, like how you want to display the decimal factors and everything. Fine. Activation type. So let us see the availability control. What is availability control? So here we mentioned that if the budget is exceeded by 80%, then it should give an error message saying that only 20% of the budget is available. If the budget is 100%, I mean, if the 100% budget is already reached, then it will give you an error message that there is no budget available. So this is dealt under availability control. As the name says, availability control means it is how much budget is still available. So activation, it says whether you want to use availability budget or not, availability control or not. Availability control deals with the error messages while the system is posting. So you can, in the same way how we discussed, like 80% is a warning message, 100% error message, that thing you can configure in the availability control. So here you are saying availability control, should be using it, or if you select the first option, which means option one, automatic activation during budget allocation. So whenever you enter a budget for this internal order, it will automatically enable availability control also. Or else if you go to background activation, which means you enter the budget and save it, then there is a batch job which will, and there is a program that will run in the background that will enable the availability control. So I will choose with the first option. And here again, it says overall or only annual values. So here we saw right, total values and annual values. Similarly, the availability control, should it consider the amount for the entire budget or only for that particular year? Like if you have entered 2020, you have entered only 10,000 and 2021 is another 20,000, another 10,000. So overall, the total value is 20,000. So it is asking whether it should verify the budget at a total level or it should verify at a yearly level. So it is always recommended that if you're entering the budget for individual years, then uncheck this one. Because what happens now, for this year, you're having 10,000 and for next year, you're having 10,000. So it says indicator which controls whether availability checks are conducted against the overall value or the annual values. So if the indicator is set, availability control checks against the overall budget. So what happens now, your overall budget for these 2 years, this year and the next year, is 20,000. Now you are posting something onto this internal order in this month and you have exceeded 10,000 rupees, you can still post it, which means you can post 15,000 this year, but for the next year, it will remain only 5,000. So in such cases, if the budget is not rigid, like it means flexible, okay, the overall value is 20,000, you can use any amount in this year and any amount in next year, like it is not equal distributions or any fixed distributions between the years, then in that case, you can go with overall. But if you want to restrict on this individual year level, like if 8,000 is exhausted, then it will say only 20% is remaining. If 10,000 is exhausted, then it will say no budget available for this year. So if you want like that, then you need to uncheck the overall. Now, object currency. What is object? Like controlling object currency. Whatever currency that we are using in our controlling area, it will verify the budget in that currency. Again here, what is a budgeting currency? Which currency will it allow you to give the budget? So whether you should be giving in controlling area currency, or it is an object currency, or you want a different currency. So something like that. So you can maintain it INR or US dollars, depending upon what currency you have configured at your controlling area level. So clear on this one? Any questions on this screen? Like what are we trying to do this?
It's clear, bro.
Okay. So save it. We don't make any changes, I think, but let us just verify what is the order and but what is the budget profile in the order type. So guys, am I going slow or am I going fast? Should I make it a bit faster or should I make it slow, or is it fine?
Yeah, it's fine for me.
Okay. And for others also, if you're having any concerns, then please do let me know.
Yeah, this space is fine.
Okay, fine. You're able to follow, right, guys? See, whenever you're not able to follow, I think the feedback option is always available once you terminate, once the session is closed. At any point of time, at any day, just give your feedback. And there's a blank section, the comment section. Just give your feedback and say, okay, this is something that you're not able to follow, or you want me to increase the pace or make things explain a bit more. Anything, we can deal with it. So unless until you say, no, I cannot understand that. So here we're having number ranges for budgeting. Similarly, we're having different number ranges. Just assign our. Okay, what is this? Fine, I think it is automatically choosing. Nothing to worry about. Okay, no worries. So see here, the next one is define tolerance limits for availability control. So we just know we discussed what is availability control. It will allow us to set some warning or error messages depending upon how much budget is utilized. So here we are setting that percentage limits, which means the tolerance limits. So here you can define like at what percentage you want what kind of error message. Oh God. Controlling internal orders, budgeting. Oh God. I am not sure this like what is happening. This looks like entire database connection. I think some issue with database connection, and I'm not sure what is happening and how can we resolve it. This is completely technical and it should be taken care by technical teams. So we will do one thing. If it does not work even tomorrow, what I will do is I will start doing it in my system. Okay. We can really create all those here and we will do it. But it is must ensure for you to ensure that the issue is resolved, because if not, you cannot practice it. If the server does not work, I can explain in this server, but you know, ultimately it is better if we do it in that server because you are practicing in that. Okay, I'll just show one thing. We'll see what is budgeting and availability control. So define tolerance limits for availability control. This looks something like this. So here what you will do is you will enter your controlling area. So when my controlling area is AVUS, so I will enter this controlling area. And for the what is the first profile, my budgeting profile is 001. So I will choose this budget profile and tolerance group. So it says what kind of an order, like it is a purchase requisition or a, like what kind of a object are you using to post onto this internal order? Like if you use this internal order for purchase requisitions, should this error messages pop up or not? Or if you're using for goods issue, or if you're using it for posting any financial document, FI document, or a CO document, irrespective of anything, we will choose as all activity groups. Like whatever activity this internal order is being used for, like you are being an FI posting, or you're using it in a purchase order, or you're being some other activity. In any case, this error message should work. So this is an action. It says what is the action that the system should take. What is happening? Yeah, so here there are options. Like you can choose, so the system should give you a warning message, or the system should give a warning message and it should also send an email to the person, or it should give an error message. So first thing I will choose as warning message, and usage and percentage, it says okay. If I reach 80% of the usage, then it should give a warning message. And the second one, again I'll choose the same budget profile, again same plus plus. Here action is I'll use 3, which means an error message. Error message should be received if I am using 100% of the budget. So that is what we are saying, that you know, depending upon how much budget is utilized, the system should give error messages based on that. Okay. clear on how we are giving the tolerances?
Yes, sir.
Okay, this part I will not do it in this one. Hopefully it will work tomorrow. If not, then you know we need to find an alternative to this. Okay, if this is the case, you know, then we will stop it here. Let me check. So what else is present? We have configured the budgeting profile, we saw the allocation structure, we saw the settlement profile, controlling internal orders, actual postings is done. Fund commitments is completely a different concept. Budgeting, we saw anything pending in budgeting. Tolerance limit, and here you're having various options like, okay, for some specific cost elements, if you do not want the budget to be, the warning to be given, like, okay, if it is, for example, there is something called as some emergency expenses. So in emergency expenses, irrespective of how much of our budget is consumed, it should not stop you from posting emergency expenses. So in that case, you will give that GL account number or the cost element number here, and it will do it. It does not perform any availability control check for that particular expenses posted using that cost element. So whenever you change your tolerance limits or whenever you are changing your budgets and everything, you know, you need to just run this option like set up availability control again. That means it will just refresh the entire budgeting and it will refresh how much budget is available and everything.